So guys, I'm going to play this red in that pocket. One position, I'm going to come for black. So again, I'm going to come one cushion like this, so that I can get this red in that pocket or this red in that pocket. So guys, I'm going to play a simple follow through. I'm going to keep my cube on nearby here so I can get black in this pocket. The angle, though the angle is not that great, guys. I think I don't want to disturb any of the red out here. See, generally in match, I would never prefer you to go for this pink. If you can play, this is the easiest shot. You can play, you can cannon this, or you can think for some other balls as well. Or you can play simple follow, which will again, it will cannon and this three red we might get in this pocket. But I don't prefer right now playing this one as I'm practicing it so that I can also check that I can play any other shots or not. So I'll play this one. And I'll try to keep my cue ball here so that I can get this red in this pocket. And if it is going little more also doesn't matter, I'm going to get that red also in this pocket. So, but again, if it is going more also doesn't matter, I can play this red also in this pocket. But right now you should focus on potting pink more. So as I told you guys, I got this red. Now I'm going to play this red and I'm going to come straightly here for black. Again, as I told you, if I can come here, so I'm getting black also, pink also in this pocket. Choice is yours, which one you want to play. This time the problem is same again. If I'm going to play a good follow also, I think it will touch fine with this trade, and I'm not sure where my cue ball is going to end up with the shot. And if I'm going to scoop back, it might happen it will touch again this, and I'm not sure again which ball I'm going to get it. So again, this time what I'm going to play is that I'm going to play simple follow so that I can get these two red holes in this pocket or this red also in this pocket. If I can. If I control till here, I can get this. That is also in this pocket. So a lot of options are there, but the follow through shot is only the good shot right now, which I can feel. Now what I'll do, I'll just simply scoop back a little bit and I can keep pink in that pocket. Guys, what I can do is that I can go till here and come for this red. If you want, I can go like this foot base also, I can get this red. So my point is to travel till here so that I can get this red also in this pocket and this red also in this pocket. So I'm getting more options. I always try to create options, that's it, guys. So see both the options I've got, as I told you. You can choose which one you want to play. Definitely I'm going to play this one because my always target is to go for pink or black. if I'm getting the option, so I'll do that only. I'll travel till here so that I can get black ops in this pocket, pink ops in this pocket again. So I've got black also, pink also, depends on you which one you want to choose. So I'll choose this, you can choose this. So I'm going to choose this one. I'm going to come one push up for this particular raid. Again, I'm going to travel like this. So if I'm not getting that, I'm going to get this raid or this raid and this one. This one. So this would be also the thing how you can actually plan out the shots, which will really help you to go further and build more break. That should be your target. Come for that, but see guys, what I was telling you, that is only happening out here. I told that I'm going to cover in this area. Why? Because I can get this also, which I have got. I've got this red also. Now see, I've got this red as well, as I told you. If you would have come little more here, I would have got this red as well and this red as well. So the target is to play this red, but I'm creating more opportunities so that even if I can't control my cue ball little bit here and there, at least I'm getting another red one. So again, I'm going to come one position for black, or I'm going to travel here. As I told you, if I travel here, doesn't matter, I can get black also, pink also. This pocket, both options I'm going to make it on for myself. That's it. So let's play the swap. Both the options is on. You can choose. Now in this shot, guys, I can try and cannon from this side so that I can get this red in that pocket. But remember, guys, if you cannon full ball, then you're not going to get any ball properly. You can only cannon the side end of it, and then what will happen? The red ball will move, and the cue ball will travel nearby here only, and it will stop here away, so that I can get this red in that pocket. But again, you can take this risk, or if you want, you can simply come screw back one cushion like this and you can clear all these reds. Generally, I would never advise you, if you are not that much skilled, to go for this shot. If you are having, at least the target should be to win the frame right now. So you should clear more reds first, so you can come for these reds as well. But as I'm practicing it, so I'm going to show you the shot, how it's going to happen. See, it just brushed a little bit, doesn't matter, but if it would have been just hit on this side, it would have been moved and the cue ball would have stood here or even here, doesn't matter, but I would have got this straight in that pocket. But anyhow, this is again a learning phase for you guys, so I just showed you the shot. Otherwise, if it would have been a frame, I would have simply scooped back one cushion for this rig, so that I can clear more reds and I leave less opportunity for my opponent to win the frame. Now in this position, I'll just simply scoot back a little bit for pink in that pocket. So guys, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to keep my cue ball here so that I want to come for this red, but if I get a good opportunity to clear this red also, I will definitely go for it. That's it. That should be my options. So I've got three reds options. Now again, I need to choose which one I want to go for and I want to clear up. Now with this, you can simply screw short and go for black. Again, if it is a match, I would never take this risk. If it's a match, I would definitely play this, not even that one, because this is much more easier one and I can come nearby here. Again, I can come up on the table. That's it. So going to do is that I'm going to play follow. One question, I'm going to travel here. Here, for this rate. But if I'm not getting this rate, doesn't matter. I'm going to get this rate in this pocket. Now, you have got this option also to come one question like this so that you can get this rate as well. Now, it depends. If it is a match, guys, I'll always go for this rate. I'll simply follow one question and go for this rate. But if you want to do, see a kind of experiment, then I can try and show you one question how I can travel like this for these 2 rates. So I can show you that if you want to see that. You can see, guys, I would have got this 2 rate little bit more if it would have come here. From here, the 2 rate is on. If it could have come like this also, the 2 rate is on. So see, just I experimented that to show you that how you can play with your shots. But if it is a match, guys, I would always prefer you to go for this rate, one cushion to come for this and to play this one easily. Though I'll play right now this one also, or I don't have this on in that pocket, so I'll play this one only. So in practice you can do this experiments, not a problem, but in match or in frames I would always tell you to go for the easiest shot, because easiest shots makes you your, you know, game easy. Okay, with this again, let me tell you what I can do. I can move till here and I can go for pink. Again, I can come down like that. I can scoot back a little bit, I can get pink. That also I can do. I can scoot back more, I can get black. So you have got plenty of options, depends on you how you want to do. I think I'll scoot back a little bit, I'll control my cue ball, I'll go for pink in that pocket. But if it is a match, guys, I'll tell you go straight wise, follow through, because 2 rates are also in the down. So you can play this blue in this pocket and go for this red as well. Guys, I'm going to play this pink in that pocket and scoop back a little bit till here for this to go for this rate. So I'm going to play this red in that pocket, one cushion. I'm going to come nearby here so that I can get pink in this pocket. So completely have come, and I'll play simple follow and I'll get this 2 rate in this pocket. I'll keep the position accordingly. So I'm going to play this red in that pocket and I'm going to keep my cue ball nearby here so that I can play black in this pocket and also get pink in this pocket. So depends on which one I want to play later on. So guys, I'm going to come one cushion like this so that if I'm coming here, I'm getting very perfectly angle for the rate. But if I'm not getting this, if it's a little bit more, doesn't matter, I'm going to get this rate also in this pocket. But the target is to play this rate. That's it. As I told you, I want to play that rate, but if somehow I couldn't control, I can get this rate. So guys, this is what you need to think. See, this is again a great idea which I want to tell you. until you get exact control, keyword control. So as I'm trying to teach you, so I would always tell you that you should always think like that. Otherwise, it might happen till the time you'll be you know, perfect or become like Ronnie O'Sullivan or Judd Trump or an international player. It might happen you can lose a lot of matches. So in matches, guys, this is the way you need to think. In the frames, you need to think like this and to create more break building. But obviously, in the practice session, just keep on trying to go for the exact weight, exact color which you want to make, because that will actually give you a lot of confidence and keyword control in your hand. It will differently come. But again, as I'm teaching you, so I'm teaching you the correct thing, correct method, so that you can start learning the things. I'm teaching you both the things. Now, depends on you how you want to apply. Now, in this position, as I told you, if I would have tried to come only for this, and suppose I would have ended here, then neither I'm getting this, neither I'm getting that properly. So again, a difficult position I've made, because it happened with me a lot of time in frames and matches. So I wanted to exactly make this one, and somehow I ended up here. So either I have to play a top pocket, or I have to play in that pocket cut short, play fine and all. I have to travel there, and I don't know where I'm traveling. So it is again a difficult shot. So never to do that. So what I have learned is that I will try not to control exactly for this. What I will do, I will try to move my keyball in such a way, in such path, that if I'm able to control, that's very fine. I'm getting this, which I'm actually looking for. If not, so that should travel in such a pace that at least I'm getting opportunity to continue my break. So this is again a good, you know, tip that you can learn from this video. Okay, so I'm going to play this one. I can play simple follow and can go for, you know, black as well, which actually I'm going to play. But if you want, you can play simple screw and you can go for pink as well. That's again your call. You can come, you know, you can play stun one cushion also, you can come for pink. But I won't do that. I will play a very simple game. I'll simply put that in that pocket. And what exactly I'm planning to do is that one cushion I'm going to come nearby so that I can get pink also in this pocket, black also in this pocket. Pink and black both. Now I should choose which one I want to choose. Obviously I'll choose black because it's very easy shot. Again, one cushion I can simply come nearby for this weight. Easy. But this time, guys, as you don't have any other option, please try to control as much as possible. At least you have got so much of plenty of zone. See, this is the zone. It means if I have to show you box wise, this is the zone you have got. You can bring anywhere in this box. Ball, then what will happen, you can at least get the potting. But if you come very far, you'll get potting, but again it will be very difficult. So keep that thing in mind. I try to come as close as possible, as near to the red ball as possible, or as you know, good position you can make, try and do that. That is more important, guys. That is what I believe. So as I told you, see, this is the box I have made. I can easily pot this one right now because I have got good option, and in the I've got again, you know, little bit of angle also, so I can create options which I want. Now here, what I do is that I'm trying to simply screw, soft screw, so that it touch one cushion, two cushion, it comes like this for black or pink. As you can see, guys, for pink or black, both are got. So guys, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to play this black in that pocket. One cushion, two cushion. I'm going to travel like this so that I can get this one also in this pocket. And if it's a little more, I can get this one also in this pocket. But the concept is to travel one cushion, two cushion like this. I can travel one cushion also, but maybe I cannot control that, so it's better to control one cushion, two cushion, and surely if I'm able to be here also, I'm going to get the red ball. But target is to play with hand, so I can come nearby to this.
Okay,
very good shot guys I have made. As you can see that exactly the way I was looking for. I have made it with hand in such a good position. I hope you have seen that. Let me move my camera so that now you can see the zone of this particular position, how I'm going to clear this reds. So from this end I'm going to show you. So guys, now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to screw back a little bit and I'm going to make brown in this pocket. Very comfortably I have made brown. I'm simply going to, you know, stop it near here so that I can get this red in this pocket. So guys, I'm going to play that red in that pocket and screw a little bit as soft as possible so I can keep nearby here for green. As I told you guys, for green. Now, I'll screw a little bit so I can get yellow in this pocket. My screw should be nearby here so I can get easily, this yellow in this pocket. So guys, I'm going to play this yellow in that pocket and screw back till here so that I can get green in this pocket easily. I'm going to put nearby till here so that I can little bit angle so I can play brown in that pocket and come for blue easily. I'm going to come one cushion like this for okay, I'm not going to come one cushion, I can come one cushion. I'm going to screw and come nearby here. I think that's a good choice actually. I'll show you the rest of the shots from again this angle so that you can understand how I'm going to clear all the whole table. So here what I'm going to do is that I can play simply follow, come like this on that pocket. I can play simply follow, I can keep like this and go for this pink in this pocket, and again I can go for black or else. Yes, but what I'm feeling is that I'm going to do that only. I'm going to come one cushion little bit in an angle so that I can go for black very easily. So just created little bit angle but not much, no problem. I'll simply play follow shot and I won't touch my cushion. I'll try to keep it nearby here. That's it. Simple play follow. I'll play. Won't try and do something which is difficult, which will make my game difficult. So guys, this is the last ball. Clear. Hopefully if I clear this differently, it will be a good one. like this video, guys. If you like this video, then please click on the share button. Click on the like button as well and subscribe to my channel if you are new to my channel. I'm sure every time I come up with a different super trade, and it definitely helps you guys like who really want to learn break building skills, because I generally focus on break building skills. And if you want to learn basic super technique, then definitely you have to contact me for that. And for that you can get even the WhatsApp number in my description, and you can contact me, and I definitely try to help you for your basic technique. Apart from that, if your basic technique is already good, then you can follow my videos, and I'm sure you're going to learn break building skills quite easily, and you will slowly and properly you will develop the skills. Thank you guys.